India's Chandrayaan 3 mission made history by becoming the fourth nation to successfully land a spacecraft on the moon. The Vikram lander and Pragyan rover delivered groundbreaking new findings about the lunar surface and unlocked clues to the moon's past volcanic activity. However, the mission failed to achieve one of its major goals, discovering water ice in the permanently shadowed craters at the lunar south pole. In this video, we'll explore what Chandrayaan 3 accomplished, how it has furthered our knowledge about conditions on the moon, and the lingering mystery of the missing water ice deposits that should be there, according to previous orbital measurements. On August 23, 2023, the Vikram lander carrying the Pragyan rover completed India's historic journey to become the fourth nation to softly touch down on the lunar surface. The touchdown itself was gentle, with Vikram firing retro rockets to cushion its fall and landing four legs into the dusty regolith below. With this milestone, India joins an exclusive club populated only by superpowers like the US, Russia, and China, who had previously achieved this complex feat of landing advanced machinery intact on an alien world. As with any off-world landing, the 7 minutes of terror on approach were nerve-wracking for ISRO scientists. The lander had to rapidly decelerate without harming itself or the delicate solar panels that powered its systems. But more than just technical prowess, this accomplishment is a point of immense national pride for India. Their space program symbolizes homegrown technological capability delivered on a modest budget. While upcoming launches of NASA's Artemis Moon program cost over $4 billion each, India developed, built, and launched the entire Chandrayaan 3 mission for a mere $75 million, running circles around the Tinseltown blockbusters with their inflated $200 million budgets. Once settled onto the surface at the outset of a two-week lunar day, Vikram lowered its ramp, allowing Pragyan to gingerly roll out onto alien soil for the first time, commencing its slow 100-meter journey investigating the terrain. From the safety of their control room, ISRO scientists viewed the barren landscape through Pragyan's onboard cameras. Guiding the plucky six-wheeled rover was tricky, thanks to a three-second communications delay. But close calls were narrowly averted, such as the rover hastily braking before toppling into a deceptive crater. In the future, semi-autonomous navigation algorithms running locally onboard rovers could reduce reliance on faraway commands. Overall, despite its short lifespan, Chandrayaan 3 delivered outsized returns during 14 days of lunar daytime by overcoming adversity to expand Indian science and engineering capabilities in space. It also engaged the public through regular updates as the solar-powered robots raced against time before night fell. This mission sets the stage for even more ambitious ISRO projects down the road, such as landings near the lunar south pole or launching probe missions to other intriguing destinations like Venus and Mars. Chandrayaan 3 came equipped with two valuable tools for deducing the lunar surface composition: the Alpha Particle X-ray Spectrometer, APXS, and the Laser-Induced Breakdown Spectroscopy, LIBS, instrument. APXS works by firing radiation at the regolith and examining the signatures of the X-ray light given off, which reveals the presence of specific chemical elements. Similarly, LIBS hits its target spot with a laser pulse, using the resulting plasma glow to discern the substances present. Together, these mobile instruments built up detailed geochemical maps of minerals and compounds as Pragyan trundled across the alien terrain. The findings illuminated a richness hiding beneath the moon's monochrome veneer. Various metals were detected in the scanned soil samples, including aluminum, calcium, iron, chromium, and titanium. The presence of these elements was expected. However, Chandrayaan 3 also uncovered signature evidence of sulfur. This marked the first definitive in-situ sulfur measurements from the lunar surface, particularly in the southern polar regions. Previously, traces of sulfur were tentatively spotted using orbital remote sensing around the Aristarchus crater. Fortuitously, the discovery of sulfur provides a crucial window into the geological past of not just the specific Vikram landing site, but also the history of the Moon itself. On Earth, sulfur largely arises from volcanic processes in our planet's active interior. Similarly, confirmation that sulfur exists on the Moon points strongly to ancient lunar volcanism that erupted flows of sulfur-rich mantle material onto the surface long ago. As these deposits later weathered, they contributed sulfur particles to regolith soil deposits over time. This upends the traditional view of the Moon as an inert world, while contributing another piece of supporting evidence that dynamic volcanism was once common across the lunar landscape. So in just 2 weeks, Chandrayaan 3 greatly advanced our comprehension of an intriguing alien sphere floating in space just 3 days from Earth. Its latest sulfur findings continue to paint a picture of a formerly vibrant, restless Moon before processes fell silent as its interior cooled. One wonders what other insights and remnants from this era lie buried or scattered, awaiting their discovery. The prospect of water ice hiding in the Moon's shadows has tantalized scientists for decades. As far back as the Apollo era, hypotheses emerged about ice possibly accumulating in peculiar craters near poles that never saw sunlight. Chandrayaan 1 in 2009 helped locate signatures of water locked away around the southern pole. But estimating precise amounts remains speculative without follow-up surface missions. Before launch, ISRO advertised Chandrayaan 3 as seeking concrete proof by directly sampling these obscure interior polar regions for the first time. Expectations grew that Vikram and Pragyan would soon gaze upon shimmering frost lakes or jagged ice spires inside these enigmatic craters. After all, orbital measurements tentatively ascribed up to 600 million metric tons of water ice waiting there. That much ice could prove invaluable for sustained lunar habitation. Water means vital drinking water for astronauts, and splitting H2O provides raw materials like hydrogen and oxygen to produce rocket fuel and breathable air. So, rather than costly resupply from Earth, the ability to live off the land by tapping polar ice mines would aid enormously in efforts to establish permanent settlements. Yet, time and again, landing spacecraft like Chandrayaan 3 have stumbled in their search for ice deposits. Vikram's spectral instruments failed to spot definitive signs of water molecules within the scanned soil composition. Meanwhile, Pragyan was forced to cautiously skirt a suspicious dark crater instead of gleefully plunging in to directly sample its cold interior contents for ice. A pattern was emerging similar to NASA's LCROSS probe in 2009, which only found traces of water following its explosive excavation of the Cabeus crater floor. Somehow, water deposits eloquently theorized from orbit perpetually elude analysis on the ground. For over 13 years since Chandrayaan 1 first sparked fascination with lunar permafrost, the mystery has deepened, with every mission returning empty-handed from the shadowy frontiers. But rather than fading hype, interest continues to grow to anchor future exploration plans around prospecting resources like hydrogen and oxygen production from suspected ice deposits. Solving the question of why unambiguous surface confirmation remains lacking is crucial to turning those dreams into reality. The daytime temperatures encountered by Vikram and Pragyan likely explain the absence of easily accessible thick water ice layers blanketing the surface. JASTI sensor data painted a picture of a scorching 60 degrees Celsius heat roasting the barren regolith just centimeters above the touchdown site. These harsh summer conditions would rapidly melt any exposed deposits before they had a chance to accumulate substantially. But curiously, Chandrayaan 3 also demonstrated remarkable variability in heat retention, moving just slightly underground. Already at 8 centimeters depth, sensors recorded a radically cooler habitat at only minus 10 degrees Celsius, despite any insulation from the broiling surface above during the long daylight. Such an extreme 100 degrees Celsius temperature swing indicates the lunar soil is a rather poor thermal conductor. Thus, while the surface bakes unprotected by any atmosphere, heat does not effectively penetrate deeper ground below. This creates enticing environments for more thermally stable reservoirs of volatile compounds to cluster in subsurface layers, avoiding fast heating and cooling cycles that crush delicate ice crystals. In fact, Vikram's observations align with heat flow measurements and models, suggesting as little as 10 to 20 centimeters could suffice for lingering water ice to resist the disruptive diurnal day-night fluctuations persisting in lunar polar regions, despite no cloud cover to trap infrared radiation given off from the ground at night. Over many epochs, any ground ice exposed by meteorites or moonquakes would evaporate during blistering daylight. But portions insulated underground would remain largely protected, potentially representing relic deposits from bygone ages. So Chandrayaan 3 indicates that a mere scratch below the desiccated surface likely waits for bounties invisible from above. Ideal ice harvesting conditions exist in these subsurface oases that maintain cold temperatures, helping fragile ice crystals endure the extreme environment compared to directly exposed spots. As missions continue to study volatile sources across the solar system, tools capable of sampling slightly beneath dusty veneers could prove pivotal in finally unearthing the coveted icy deposits hypothesized for decades from orbit. Chandrayaan 3 has expanded our knowledge about volatile transport cycles and the evolution of resources on the Moon. The subsurface represents our best bet for one day mining useful compounds like hydrogen, oxygen, and of course, precious water ice. Chandrayaan 3's contributions will aid that goal of establishing a lasting human presence on the Moon.